This is Wally Mandela to all African brothers and sisters in the diaspora, especially in the motherland. It's all in you. Some have made mistakes and have gone abroad, only to tell their folks back home to stay put where they are. And these folks respond, why don't you come back? Answer to that question, he or she can't come back just like that. He or she left Africa thinking, I'm gonna be working on Euro, pounds, dollars, yen, thinking these hard currency are gonna be dropping on my head like snowballs. He or she thought, I ain't gonna lift a finger. All I need is back this gold in the Ghana must go and send to Africa. He or she gets abroad and finds out, I ain't got no paper, I am illegal. Without legal papers, you're running from town to town, city to city, state to state, east coast, west to east. You can't settle down. No good job, you're making next to nothing. You get caught, you're in jail. You don't get caught, you sleep on the street. You get out of trouble, you get you a citizen and hook up for a green card. If you're lucky to get a green card, you pay through your nose. Oftentimes, you ain't so lucky, you end up in jail. On the flip side, say you go abroad with legal papers, 98% of the time you start from the scratch. From square one, y'all, call it culture shock. Your spoken English is different, no matter where you're coming from. No matter your level of education, you get abroad and you start all over. Begin again. Start competing with high school dropouts. We will heap insults on you like you never heard of before. Check this out. How's the jungle? When you going back to the jungle? Why you come over here to take our jobs? Did you swim across the ocean? You play with monkeys? Do you wear clothes? Do they ride cars in Africa? Brother, sister, you already left your decent job in Africa. You sold your car off. You sold your house. You know that thing called shame? It won't let you go back. You are now a security officer, a nursing assistant, washing doo-doo, a cab driver, a factory worker, a restaurant, Burger King, McDonald's attendant, a gas, filling station attendant. Here is a graduate from Africa, making next to nothing. You got bills and taxes to pay, and you can't stay too long with your benefactor. Remember that guy, girl, that took you in? Before long, he or she kicks you out. Now, you are on your own. O-Y-O, like they say in Niger. Some soon find out the truth about their friends. Send them flashy cars to Africa, wearing gold all over, spraying hot currency on praise singers. They found out these guys are criminals, credit card fraudsters, drug peddlers, swindlers, 419ers, Yahoo boys and girls, name it. But they soon get caught anyway. Maybe 10 years, 20 years, they get caught no matter what cost. They've been watched. Watch this. The real problem is, the foreign media painted abroad as heaven with streets of gold where no finger is lifted, but gold is easily picked up. The same media painted Africa as AIDS-infested jungle, swarming with animals without any basic amenities. African leaders are weird, and most ain't doing jack to challenge this, whether verbally or through good governance. But the media lie. You and I know there are ghettos the world over. There are more homeless abroad than in Niger, cause Africans are their brother's keepers. It's not what you like, your time, your money, your energy. You can make it here. It's all in you. I remember November 97. I came out and saw some white stuff falling from the sky. I thought it was manna, but it felt cold, ice cold. I found out this is snow. Brothers and sisters, can you imagine wearing a skull hat, yet it feels like your head is stuck in a bucket of ice. Your hands and feet numb from minus 15 degree cold. You're wearing three clothes and a thick jacket, yet you're shaking like a hand out of water. Gloves on your hands and thick boots on your feet, yet you feel no blood flowing. Dead in the night, you're on the street waiting on bus to go to work. You dare not come late 1 minute. This is the snow season abroad. It's winter time. It's not what you like. Time, money, energy. You can make it here. It's all in you. Many have gone abroad and perished in jails. Many got deported after so many years. Many are stuck on the streets of America, Europe, Asia, Australia, and can't make it back home. There are those who haven't called their folks in Africa once in 10 years. There are those who died in Iraq because they embarked on the journey through the back door. Some ended up in other African countries because they soon find out it's way too tough to get to their destination. You can make it here because it's all in you. Why would you want to jump to your death from story buildings rather than go back to your country? Africans jump to their death abroad while running from the law. You can make it here and visit over there with a lot of respect. Yes, you can, because it's all in you.